is my lightly used M6L Brompton. And because this is a compulsive DIY channel, I'm planning to modify it. The plan is to convert the 6-speed transmission to a 14-speed Rohloff Speed Hub, which is why this project is going to be called Project Brommieloff. I like to give code names to my projects. The Rohloff Speed Hub is amazing. It has 14 equally spaced speeds. It can be shifted, with the exception of one gear, under any circumstances, even standing on pedals and climbing hills. But it has one drawback, it's heavy. I've already built the rear wheel with a Rohloff hub right here. The weight of this hub is clearly an issue. I'm also planning to add a generator hub up front. So to deal with these issues, I'm planning to use some lightweight titanium parts like this rear triangle that I got from China. And so there will be questions about quality of these parts, the fit and finish of these parts, and also whether the weight savings will offset much of the weight gain that will happen with the Rohloff hub in the back and the generator hub on the front. So I'm planning to go over this carefully in the upcoming videos. For the cool factor, I'm also putting on hydraulic disc brakes just because I want to feel young, and it seems like all the young guns have hydraulic disc brakes these days. The people who make these products, these modification parts, do provide disc brake attachments. I'm not the first one to do this project. This very excellent book about the history of Brompton by David Hanshaw has an example of a Rohloff Brompton. It's this red one on page 135. So certainly this has been done before, but I'm planning to document every step on video, and I'm sure there will be glitches that will be worth discussing. So I'm ready to get started. The first video will be about disassembling this bike and putting the new rear triangle and the new fork on. Disassembly is the next step. Difficult point in this disassembly. These screws and the pivot are known to be very difficult to remove. I'm gonna try with this hammer, but that's unlikely to work. They usually have to be drilled out. I'm going to try this impact driver on this 4mm Allen head bolt, but my hope is low that this has enough energy to loosen this. As I mentioned, Brompton sends a drill bit with the overhaul kit. for this assembly. All right, so I got the 6mm drill bit. It is a 6mm screw. Although the pivot, of course, will be unusable afterwards, so all of this is being thrown out. I got the safety glasses on, ready to go with a little cutting oil here. Can see I'm not quite in the center. I'm going to use a slightly larger drill. So 6.5 millimeter drill was quite perfect to get this head out. I'm pleased with that. And so I was wondering if I could just push this out to the other side, in a way drift it out. But as I'm thinking of it, the answer is no, because the axle doesn't fit through the pivot, so both sides have to be drilled out. Actually, drilling this out was quite easy with a 6.5 millimeter drill bit. There's some kind of a red product, so I bet it's a hard permanent Loctite. That's on everything here. And these are the famous bushings which require a specialized reamer to get them to accept. This axle. So the steel rear triangle is out. The titanium one is about to go on after I clean up the chips from this drilling out operation. But first I'm going to weigh them side by side before I put the titanium one on. So the weigh-in is done. The original Brompton part is 780 grams. This titanium eBay triangle is 534 grams. So it's a 246 gram saving with the titanium part, and I can feel it with this hand here. I'm saving additional 15 with the titanium pivot. So it's 261. That's favorable given the weight of the Rohloff hub. All right, so I'm starting to run into the fit issues that I feared with my Chinese components here from eBay. This is the drilled out original pivot axle, let's call it, and it's steel. And this is the aftermarket eBay Chinese replacement part made out of titanium. It's 15 grams lighter. I can't weigh them for comparison on my scale because I drilled it out, so there are pieces of bolts left in there. But it's 15 grams lighter, and this original steel one is very easy to fit through there with fingers, with my fingers. Of course, it's been in service, so there's a little wear from that, but fits quite easily. the aftermarket titanium part. Actually, it does now as well. I couldn't fit it in at first, actually, so it is quite good. I couldn't fit it in, so I put some thick transmission oil in there in anticipation of installing it. And now that it's oiled up, it actually fits quite well. Well, up to here. So, not as easily, but I think a gentle nudge with a mallet will do it. So, almost as easily. So, let me see how easy it goes in with a mallet. And if saving 15 grams by not buying a genuine Brompton part was worth it. Actually, I can push it with my hand here. Now this was easy enough. So the first lightweight part is in. I've already saved 15 grams, yay. A couple of words about how the Brompton pivot works. Inside the steel mainframe are two bronze bushings. You can see these bronze bushings here on the right side of this overhaul kit. You can buy these bushings for the purposes of the overhaul. And the axle, which you also see in this kit, rotates inside the bushings. The rear triangle is rigidly screwed to the axle with the two screws, and there are these plastic spacers that keep metal from rubbing. The bronze bushings are pressed in place, and when they're pressed in place, they're undersized. They have to be reamed to size with this special tool. It's a Brompton part number QHR ream. It's expensive. I understand it costs over 200 pounds and it's difficult to buy. But this reamer is a piloted reamer which provides the alignment and reams the two bushings to final size after they're installed. And in case you're wondering what the tap is for, the tap is used to pull out the old bushings. The old bushings are sort of threaded with this tap and then extracted by either pulling or knocking the tap with the bushing out. It's a wonderful design because, first of all, you have a proper bronze bearing, but also it's possible to overhaul this unlimited number of times and end up with a brand new pivot. So Brompton did a fantastic job, or I should say Andrew Ritchie did a fantastic job designing this overhaulable setup. I wish the reamer was cheaper and easier to find. In my case here, the Brompton is almost new. I'm using a new pivot axle. So I put the new pivot axle into the almost new rimmed bushings, and you could see that I could almost push it in with my fingers. I'm doing it without Loctite first because I don't know how many times I'll have to take it apart before everything fits as it's supposed to. All right, so dimensions were correct on this made in China part. It's not quite as loose as the original, and I showed earlier how it went in a little tighter, but I think it's loose enough where after a few fold-unfold cycles, I'll be good. So far, so good. This is called the Nuff Design Racing Shock. It's a metal, I think it's a titanium cylinder here. I'm not quite sure how good this is going to work, but I bought it strictly for its looks. I didn't completely understand that there isn't much of a shock absorption to it, so I might have to go back to a stock suspension, but for now, this looks good. This is a large bolt and may be worth replacing it with titanium for grams. Yep. Oh, they greased it super generously over there in London. Gotta have a headset remover tool like this, otherwise it's nearly impossible. There we go. By the way, I'm removing it because I have a nicer Chris King headset for this project. Wasn't very elegant. So I just weighed them off camera on my kitchen scale on the table right here. And the original Brompton headset is 164 grams. And this black Chris King headset I'm about to install is 110. So I'm saving 54 grams on the headset. Look at how clever Chris King is. The top and bottom headset cups look similar, but they print their name on them in correct orientation, so you don't want your King to be upside down, so you instantly know where they go. Thank you. click. Let's check alignments. Like the word king forward like this. Better and lighter. Chris King headset is pressed in. Gotta put this away. This is the fork that's going in, so it has a normal front bicycle fork, 100 millimeter spacing, and it has this IS disc brake attachment. I'm gonna be using a normal generator hub. By normal, I mean 100 millimeters wide. Just slides in. Almost. I just gently persuaded it into its seat with a rubber mallet. No special tool required. I should say a soft plastic mallet. Grease the threads because I'm screwing aluminum on titanium. Probably not as critical as when screwing steel onto titanium. Pretty smooth. Putting the stem back on. I'm gonna buy a titanium stem bolt for in there. It's a very large bolt, and so substantial weight savings may be possible. I should have thought of this earlier. I'm thinking of using a plastic spacer here from the Brompton headset so that this steel doesn't sit on the Chris King nut. I looked at it and it's not possible. This is a plastic ring that is made specifically for this nut. So it wouldn't be elegant to just have it sit there. So Chris King headset is nice, but it'd be nice to have a plastic spacer here, but we'll do without it for now. Forget how it sits. It sits approximately like this. there's the contact. It's actually not that bad. There's a shoulder there on the lower casting of the stem that I think is interacting well with the Chris King. Tighten it because that's the one I'm planning to replace with a titanium bolt. Alright, so here is the new 100 millimeter fork that's on, and I am pleased. And I forgot to mention that the stock Brompton fork is 234 grams heavier than my titanium fork. I'm putting on this titanium handlebar. It has a low rise compared to the Brompton original. I think this height will be just right for me. It is also slightly wider, just a few centimeters wider. I forget how many millimeters. I just think Brompton's handlebar is too narrow for comfortable riding. This is 20 grams lighter. Of course, it's missing some metal on this vertical part, but it added some on the ends. So titanium handlebar, weight-wise, provides very few grams advantage over aluminum. So aluminum handlebars are quite light already. Hard to do better. And the last thing I have to swap is the telescoping seat post, which I don't need because I'm not that tall. But this bike came with it, so it would have been lighter on the original weigh-in if it didn't come with the telescoping seat post like this. I just replaced this original telescoping seat post, which came with the bike, which I never needed. So that makes it for a bit of an unfair comparison, but that's okay. Replaced the original telescoping seat post with this titanium anodized gray seat post, which looks very nice. And this is the biggest weight saving maneuver I've done so far. This saved me 378 grams. As I come to the end of part one here, where I replace the forks and other major frame related components, I'm preparing to put on the new Rohloff rear wheel, which I made. The Rohloff wheel is 966 grams heavier with this velocity rim and with this disc brake rotor. And with the cable adapter that's off right now. This wheel is 966 grams heavier, so almost a kilo heavier than the 6-speed Brompton wheel with the Sturmey Archer 3-speed hub and 2 sprockets. Here I do have the sprocket on. So where do I stand right now? I know I will be gaining 966 grams. As soon as I put this wheel on the back. I will use this picture of the finished bike to illustrate where I stand with the weight so far. First of all, I got a titanium S stem. I got it for ergonomic purposes primarily, but I did save 356 grams when I replaced my M with this S stem, and the savings would have been over 400 grams if it was an even S for S swap. Fork, headset, and stem bolt, the titanium stem bolt that I added, saved 302 grams. Seat post was 378 gram savings. And the rear triangle with the titanium pivot together was 261 grams saved. As I already mentioned, this rear wheel with the Rohloff hub weighs almost 2.5 kilos and is 966 grams heavier than the Brompton Sturmey Archer six-speed wheel. What I haven't mentioned yet is that my front wheel with the 100 millimeter Watson Deluxe dynamo hub and a disc brake is 416 grams heavier than the Brompton's stock 632 gram radial wheel. This brings me to the end of part one of Project Brommieloff. Part two will be about drivetrain and Rohloff shifting mechanism. I will be able to save a little weight with the bottom bracket, but as you can see, the weight gains from Rohloff hub and my heavy generator hub are about offset by the weight loss from my titanium parts. So far so good. At least I'm not ending up with a 50 kilo Brompton. Thanks for watching and join me for part two.